Hello, this is Simone, and we have a great show for you today on ARoadRetraveled.
Hello, this is Simone, and welcome to ARoadRetraveled. Let's go.
We have a special guest for you today, Bridget Pollard. She's an animal communicator from Portland, Oregon, and she is here to talk to us today about communicating with animals. So we're going to find out what is an animal communicator and how we can develop our own skills and some more interesting stories about Bridget and her life as an animal communicator. And we also have a mini reading on Pepito. Pepito is my little chihuahua, and those of you who have seen his little videos or heard me talk about him on Twitter will know who he is. He is my beloved little boy, and I cannot wait to hear what Bridget has talked to him about. I hope he hasn't given away any secrets. I'm very excited about today's show, so let's get started. Bridget, welcome to ARoadRetraveled. It's very exciting for me to talk to you today. And I have Pepito here with me because we're talking about dogs and animals and our beloved pet, and he's kissing me right now. I think he likes you and he's letting me know. And welcome, and I've been looking forward to this interview for so long because I'm very excited to hear what you have to say about animal communicators. And welcome to the show.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
It's my pleasure. Let me ask you first, what is an animal communicator?
An animal communicator is someone who talks with animals. We will ask an animal a question and we'll get information back from that animal that we can then share with the owner. The information that we get may come in the form of words or a picture or a smell or an emotion. We put all these little pieces together to give the owner a real understanding of what the animal is thinking or feeling.
How did you find out that you had this ability, and what have you done to develop it?
Well, I originally found out when I heard my dog talking to me late one night. She was a foster dog who had recently come to live with our family, and she was very upset about the transition. I was very surprised to hear her, and I avoided this gift for a couple of years because I just didn't want to be that person who talked with animals. I didn't want to, you know, be the woo-woo person that, you know, people thought was strange. It took me a while to get used to this idea. And then I realized that I had this really wonderful gift and that I could use it to help people and to help pets. So I started talking with every animal that I could. And I asked friends and colleagues and people I barely knew to give me a picture of their pet, a few questions, to let me answer those questions, and then to have them validate whether my answers were right or not. And it took about a year of doing this to feel really comfortable with what I was doing. I also learned how to meditate quite a bit during that time, so I was able to more easily kind of come into my own and reach that point of understanding. And I found that I was not only able to do it, I'm pretty good at it. It wasn't too hard to learn. And then I started teaching other people how to do it.
When you communicate with an animal, do you use all of your senses? Do you have a stronger sense that the animal's energy comes through to you?
Yeah, every animal communicator and every animal will have certain senses that are their strengths. So, for example, it's very easy for me to hear an animal speak words to me. When I'm talking to an animal that uses words well, then we can have a very easy and articulate conversation. Sometimes I will come across an animal that only wants to use pictures to communicate, And so I have to infer from those pictures what the animal is trying to tell me. That's much more difficult for me. There are animal communicators who are much more visually oriented, and so they would find that more comfortable. They would get more information from those pictures than what I get from those pictures. It's a multi-sensory experience in that animals may substitute pictures for words they don't know. So for example, the other day I was talking with a dog who wanted to tell me that the Kong toy that it had was hurting its teeth. And he said, "This toy," and then he showed me a picture of the toy, "hurts my teeth." And he showed me how his teeth felt. So I got words, I got a picture of the toy, and I got the sensation of physical pain in my mouth. So sometimes it's a little bit of a puzzle putting it together.
Wow. Now, in a day of an animal communicator, can you turn off these senses? Or say, for example, you're walking around one day and you end up in a zoo. What would that be like for you?
I think it would be a little overwhelming. To some extent, I can definitely shut this off. I don't walk around hearing animals everywhere I go. But if I'm not paying attention, I'll suddenly hear someone and realize that there is an animal within my vicinity that has something to say, you know, if I'm not consciously tuning it out. I think if I went to a zoo, it would be difficult. I'm sure there are some animals that enjoy their captivity, but I have a feeling that there are some that don't. And I have this issue sometimes where animals will realize that I can hear them, and then they really want to talk to me. And I'm concerned that if I went to a zoo, it would be animals saying, "Hey, you understand me? Get me the heck out of here. Tell my zookeeper that I need more peanuts or something." It'd be an awkward situation.
What has been your most memorable or funny experience communicating with an animal?
I had a dog the other day tell me that, you know how people can be left-handed or right-handed? He told me that he was left-nosed. He was left nostril. So he liked to smell things with the left side of his face, and so he'd always kind of go in from the left.
I thought that was hilarious. Left nose. That is too funny.